have been on the old agua, you know, the old water for the most of the time, which is a bit of a change from the previous week's adventures. But as always, as most great philosophy will tell you, a good life is a balanced life, right? Knowing the limits of excess is good, and no, and being able to actually rein yourself in without somebody else reining you in is always very honorable, and something, a skill that you probably only learn the older you get. You know, the ability to kind of like look at yourself through maybe a third, third person. You know, like on the Call of Duty games, and you're like standing. No, Call of Duty is first person, but you can have a view that's sort of like third person. That is how you want to look at your life. You want to analyze yourself from there, or from like a drone sort of fashion, right? And see where you're going, see the pitfalls, and then be like, you know what? I'm not going to do that. But sometimes there are occasions where life is just more fun when you just take that right corner, right? That right corner that leads you right into trouble, where you know you're going to fuck up, or you know you're going to have to, you know, explain yourself. It might spice things up a little bit, but for the most part, it's best that you are able to rein it in. So for you guys are out there feeling a bit rough and having a bit of a headache, I do not despise you. I do not envy you, and I hope that your head is pounding up until Tuesday, and that you make the necessary changes that you need to make in order to make sure you live a successful and fruitful life. I've actually been binging on some random videos that I found on YouTube recently of YouTubers who have been going through recovery, right? So the people that kind of make those videos and like, oh, you know, I was going through so many problems and I quit everything and now look at me, I look amazing. And yeah, fair enough, there's a lot of dudes that look really cool, right? They look amazing, they look really great, and I'm happy that is the case. But there's this guy in particular who kind of really scared me a little bit. Let me see if I can get him up on the screen. But it's a quite a cool little subculture, right, of these recovery addicts on YouTube kind of being really forthright and putting themselves out there. Because, you know, I'm sure those kind of things aren't very fun. They're not something that you want to kind of publicize. It's something that you probably keep close counsel with to your friends and family. But for the most part, seeing as YouTube is that place for all everything and anything, I'm not surprised it's happening. So this one dude that I kind of stumbled upon, who had no idea who he was prior to kind of, you know, checking out some of the stuff on the old tube of you, right, was this dude here. Let me see if I can get him up quickly. This guy called Mod Sun, right? I'm not sure if you guys have heard of him or you know who he is, but supposedly he used to go out with Bella Thorne, who's, you know, all over the internet these days. But this dude, right, has kind
18
of,
years
well,
old. I
let me try
started
and mute him.
touring
Yep. Well,
at the time. I started touring when I
yeah, let me try and pause him. So anyway, he goes through his entire video and he's essentially kind of talking about his addiction, right? The stuff that's kind of occurred, what's kind of gone on. But the troubling thing about it, not, you know, the setting is quite troubling, but you know, it's quite cool because he's in supposedly a Jim Morrison hotel. Jim Morrison, famous of the Doors fame, as you know, who died tragically, I think at 28 too. I think he might be part of the 28 Club, Jim Morrison. But anyway, it's an amazing room that supposedly Jim Morrison stayed in back in the day in LA. It's kind of plastered with graffiti all over it, and I think for the most part, it's like an addict shrine, right? So I think if you're an addict or if you're a bit off the rails, you probably go to LA, find Jim Morrison's room, and decide to, like, you know, do lines of amphetamines all over the bed and shit. Maybe similar to what people do when they go to Pablo Escobar's grave. And they sniff lines off of it, so maybe it's one of those kind of stuff. But anyway, the room I'm assuming is now been turned into some sort of rehab facility or whatever, maybe, because I wouldn't think a former addict would want to go into a room that, you know, might have some residue of drugs in it. But he's in this room, it looks fairly cool. He's doing all the malarkey, but then he sits down and talks to the camera, right? And it's a fairly cool interview. I think I'll link it in the show notes if you guys want to kind of listen to it yourself. But the scary part of it is this Mod Sun dude is the same age as me. That's the scary part, right? So obviously, you know, I'm sure this dude has, he's probably lived 17 lives, right? He's had an amazing time. He's done all the things that he wanted to do in life. He's, you know, dated the hottest women. He's worn the most expensive garments, flown to the most luxurious places, right? He's been in the places that everyone dreams of being in. But in terms of what he looks like physically, like, he looks like a bag of balls, isn't it? Like, this guy's the same age as me, the same age. And I think there are times in life where you probably need to pull yourself back just when it's about to get crazy. And maybe he's pulled himself back just when it was about to get over the edge, right? He could have, you know, this could have been a tragic case of, you know, all the other number of entertainers who kind of fall by the wayside, but luckily he was able to pull himself back. But this is what kind of, it didn't scare me into anything, but I'll just, it's funny whenever you're thinking about something yourself, you tend to stumble upon that thing anyway. It's kind of like a reaffirmation of what you're thinking about. And I guess I was just thinking about it in general, and like how ridiculous it is sometimes to be in a space where you're surrounded by kids who are like half your age, going through experiences that you went through 15 years ago, right? And then you're there, right? Just like cramping up the space. I kind of imagine it like, imagine your cool uncle happens to like pop by the bar that you're in as well with your friends, right? It's your cool uncle. You don't mind him, right? But he's in your space now. It's a bit awkward. Even if you don't mind hanging around with him and having a couple of shots, he's still in your space. So as I imagine, it must be like if you're a kid kind of experiencing Dawson, New York, LA, wherever else, Paris, Berlin. If you experience those places for the first time and you just happen to have, you know, loads of old fogies like myself and other people hanging around just, you know, crusty in a corner. And yeah, I think Morton is maybe a good example of it. It might be a bit mean to say, but you know, again, he's in recovery mode now. He's doing fairly well, it seemed, by the lack of it. And again, it's a pretty cool video. It's very in-depth, very raw, very personal. It's about 46 minutes long, so I recommend you check it out yourself. I'm not going to play the entire thing on this podcast now, but yeah, a very interesting video. So for those of you who are feeling bad about it, so probably don't watch it today. Maybe watch it on Monday if you want some motivation, whatever it may be. But yeah, a very interesting video from this dude called Modson. Again, I'm not very familiar with Modson. I don't really know what they do or what they get up to and stuff like that, malarkey. I think they're probably a really successful group, aren't they, for the most part? I'd imagine so. Let's have a quick little Google and see how popular this Modson group is. I'm assuming, or he is. He's really popular, I'm assuming, right? Isn't it? Oh, sorry, Modson is separately. So, Modson, according to Wikipedia, Derek Smith, known professionally as Modson, is an American rapper, author, rock musician, and poet from Bloomington, Minnesota. Yeah, from a small town, went to the big lights in LA. Not surprised, lost himself a bit. Blah blah blah. He's born, yep, so the same age. What else about him? Music career. He's got loads of albums out. Nothing about. Okay, not that much about him. He's written a couple books too, which is quite cool. So he wrote a non-fiction book in 2012, a poetry book in 2015, and a couple of journals. That's nice. So yeah, fairly accomplished lad. Looks like a bag of balls, but he's now putting himself together. So again, big up Modson. Great video, very raw and honest, and let's see what happens now going forward. Did their relationship have some sort of rocky past? Because there's a video here of Bella Thorne talking about her ex-boyfriend. Let's see what that's about, actually. What's Bella Thorne talking about here? So it's weird.
I talking did read about in public. Let's your see. Ex trying to turn into fucking 50 Cent all of a sudden, trying to get money off of you. I'm like, what the fuck? So how do we get your shit out of his place?
It's, what? Yeah, that's, yeah, it's a long one. Like, just leave it.
I know. Like, fuck him.
Well, you know, my computer was definitely, my computer and my passport, I just recently missed this big work opportunity I had to do because of this passport situation, and I needed my script writing computer back. That was,
man, that's it, innit, for millennials, really, isn't it? That's your key possession: smartphone, laptop, tablet of choice, and a passport. That's really all you need. Essentially, if your house or your apartment went up in flames, that's the only thing you'd really be caring about. You'd be bothered about, really, in general, wouldn't it? Be your computer, your passport, and your phone of some sort. Even the phone, probably, could probably do without the phone, because you've got everything on the cloud. You could, you know, again, it's going to cost you an arm and a leg, I know, but if I had to choose between my phone and my laptop, I'd probably burn my phone, right? You could probably get back and up on your feet with a couple of Samsungs, you know, in between. That's essentially all you need. So imagine it being all in your ex-boyfriend's house and you can't get a hold of it. And you're an actress or, you know, a screenwriter part-time, I'm guessing, Bella Thorne is, because she's talking about her script-writing computer, which is quite a cool idea, really, isn't it? That means you don't have any distractions, you don't have any other apps that you're using. But yeah, I'm guessing it's a very tumultuous experience. Let's see what else she has to say about this, because it doesn't seem that bad, really. It's really hard to get stuff in people's houses, even if you didn't date someone. It's hard to get something from someone's house. Have you ever been to a house party and you forgot something and you tried and get it from your friend? It just takes ages. So imagine if there was love involved there and swapping of saliva. It's going to be even more difficult.
That was a big one, but all the rest of the shit, I mean, there is this Fendi coat that I just love. There's this Fendi coat, but the rest, I'm just like, it's really the main, the script writing. I mean, I'm finishing my series, like, I, you know, anyway. It's final draft.
It's your work.
It's my computer. And my password. And my wallet. I need it back, please.
So funny. God damn, man. She's got an ugly laugh, isn't it? Mamma mia.
An ex burned all of my shit.
Oh my goodness.
All of my shit, including all my baby photos. And I was like, no.
motherfucker. But your baby photo. Oh no, your baby photos. No, that's what the fuck.
Well, that was a very enlightening conversation, wasn't it? For the most part.